This is going to be a quick update to the SynthEdit LFO tutorial I made recently. I made a mistake and didn't set it up correctly. I knew there was something off because it didn't sound right when I played some notes, but I couldn't figure out why. I skipped playing the subtle vibrato example because I couldn't get it to sound good. Once I sat down and did the math, I figured out what the problem was. Normally, an oscillator is used to produce an audible sound wave. Human hearing ranges from 20 Hz to 20 kHz, which means that for a sound wave to be audible, it must be within that range. An LFO, on the other hand, is a non-audible signal, producing a wave that falls between 0 and 20 Hz. We use that signal to modulate other signals, such as the volume, pitch, etc. So, let's take a look at the problem. In the LFO video, I set the oscillator to respond to 1 volt to 1 octave. So 1 volt being passed into the oscillator will raise the pitch by 1 octave. Then, the slider that controls the rate was set to produce a max voltage of 0 and a minimum voltage of negative 10. That means we're sending in way too much voltage, which is causing the LFO to not perform correctly. This is an easy fix, though. What we need to do first is set the oscillator's frequency scale to 1 volt to 1 kilohertz. That means if I pass in 1 volt to the oscillator, it will produce a 1 kilohertz wave, or 1000 hertz. Our LFO needs to operate between 0 and 20 hertz. All we need to do is change the slider's low value to 0, and the high value to 0.02. Remember, 1 volt is equal to 1 kilohertz, and 1 kilohertz is equal to 1000 hertz. So to have a maximum value of 20 hertz, we need the slider to produce a maximum of 0.02 volts. Now, when I mess around with the rate and depth, the LFO performs as expected. Sorry to make an update like this. I wish I would have got it right the first time, but understanding how the LFO works and getting it performing correctly is vital to the next project we're going to be working on. By the way, the tempo sync LFO we made works fine. This only applies to the LFO using the rate slider we created a couple videos back. I want to give a little bonus tip that Grinder1 left in a comment on the last video. This is something I had no idea about and can be really useful for cleaning up your layout. If you left-click a patch cord, it becomes highlighted. If you left-click it again, you'll add a node, and you can route the cord how you like. Also, if you left-click a cord once, and then right-click it, you can choose to straighten line, which will revert the cord back to its original state, or choose curvy, to add a curve to the line. Maybe you guys knew about this, but I had no idea. So I really like this tip, and I want to say thanks to Grinder1 for sharing.